and welcome to this podcast series, where we will discuss about the topics related to pharmaceutical and healthcare industry. This series is brought to you by RAS Life Science Solutions, which is primarily a healthcare-focused strategy consulting firm. In this whole series, we will cover the topics related to product development, clinical development, product strategy, and launch readiness, and many more. So, let's tune in. In today's episode, we will discuss about the fundamentals of market intelligence in an easy-to-understand language. So here, I, Sakshi Saini, is joined by Aditya Bahl, who is the founder and CEO of RAS Life Science Solutions. So,
hello.
We welcome Aditya.
Thank you very much for having me. Hello.
Hi. Thanks for joining us today. So let's start with our basics first. What does market intelligence primarily mean? How do we define it?
Good question. So let's open up a visual for the benefit of our audience. Uh-huh. And so when you think about market intelligence, my suggestion would be to think about a five-force model propagated by Professor Michael Porter. Essentially, in this model, as you can see on the slide, you have five main actors. The first one being the market leaders. They stand in the center. They shape the environment with regards to their pricing policy. They shape the environment with regards to how they set up the supply chain. Mm-hmm. Then you have on the top left, as you can see, new entrants. These are essentially companies that are trying to produce similar products, or let's say marginally differentiated products as compared to market leaders. Mm-hmm. Then you have the customers on the right side, top right, which are essentially all the individuals who will either pay for the product or consume or both, and also set up the policy. So in the case of pharmaceuticals, it would be patients, payers, physicians, and governments. Mm-hmm. Then you have disruptors who are essentially trying to evaluate different ways of solving the problem. Or in terms of, in the pharma context, these would be individuals who are coming up with cell therapies, gene therapies, as compared to symptom suppressants. And then you have suppliers, like, again, from a pharma point of view, like clinical research organizations, bulk suppliers, formulation providers, who have a role to play in how the industry evolves. Now, market intelligence is, and the sum total of all the behaviors and how they influence how the industry evolves.
Aha. Okay. So, for example, if I can just try to paraphrase you. Anything what needs to be done to be in the market is market intelligence.
Correct. That would be correct.
Okay. So now we have established the basics. What does market intelligence essentially mean? I was wondering, for our audiences, how is it relevant to pharma?
So let's try and understand this from another visual. So what you notice in this particular visual, if you focus only on the two extremes of this visual, mm-hmm. you, on one hand, you see on the left side, you see this innovation. This is where the fundamental research in biology is happening. Mm-hmm. New ideas about how disease is contracted, how it progresses, what happens to the body, what happens at a molecular, at a cellular level. Mm-hmm. On the extreme right, what you see is the customers. These are the individuals who are, for example, patients who are going to consume the product, physicians who are going to prescribe the product, insurance guys or payers who are going to pay for the product, and governments who set the policy making as it relates to how the products will come to the market. Mm-hmm. The line joining between the two of them is the clinical research and development. Now, this line is essentially anywhere from 5 to 10 years long, and it can cost anywhere from $1 to $2 billion of expense. And it is also marked by extreme, or let's say very significant competition, because if we are developing one product, so are others for a particular disease. And the third thing that complicates this journey is the risk of failure. The product can fail at any point in time, which also means that the sunk costs are essentially useless till that point in time. Right. But when you look into, so as a pharma company, if we are developing a product which is anywhere from 5 to 10 years away from the market, it becomes super critical for us to be to have a sense of what the how the market is evolving, and at least a vision, at least a methodology to be able to predict what the market would look like when a product does come to the market. And if you think about it, analysis of how the market is evolving, a foresight of how the market will evolve or how it will look like is market intelligence. Given the high risk, given the high competition, given the high ever-evolving behavior expectations of the customers, it becomes even more critical as compared to maybe a consumer product.
Okay. So when you explain it that way, it actually kind of makes sense. So I was actually thinking, if RAS being a primarily a healthcare-focused strategy consulting firm, in all of this diagram which you just explained, where does it actually essentially operate?
Okay. So let's take out another visual, so for the benefit of our audience, so that we can explain what we do that much better. All right. When we discussed the previous question, we talked about the foresight of how the customer expectations are evolving and what will they be in a few years from now. Now, that's customer insights, market research. We discussed what the competition is doing because there are other people who are developing the products also. That's competitive intelligence. Now, both of these elements are essentially external environment. Then we also have to look inwards to understand what our capabilities look like, what our predispositions are, and to be able to benchmark the two or juxtapose the two to come up with some sense of where our opportunities look like. That would be situation analysis. We offer all three. Now, when you're looking at the future, when we are trying to understand how the future would look like, essentially, you think in terms of scenario. So we offer also scenario planning, scenario analysis workshops. And sometimes you also need to get deep into the mind of another company, in which case you do company profiling. And we actually specialize very well in that. These would be the some of the services that we offer along with others.
So when we look at this slide, it actually kind of gives you an idea that RAS actually caters to a very, very broad clientele.
That would be correct.
Coming back to what you just said, I actually noticed that you alluded to these terms, situation analysis and scenario planning. Would you please elaborate on a little bit on this?
Okay, so let's take the term situation analysis first. We did touch upon it in the previous question, but let's just dive a little bit deeper. We discussed the fact that when we try and understand what our competitors are doing, that falls under competitive intelligence. It gets us a sense of what the competitor mindset is, what is the overall strategy associated with a given product, with a given indication or disease, or their overall corporate strategy. Then we are also, of course, we discuss the customers, so we can have a piece of market research that is purely focused on physicians, focused on patients, focused on peers and policymakers, and trying to understand how they individually look into a particular situation. In our context, happens to be a disease. And what does it take to take care of the disease? Because a patient's view is going to be different from that of a doctor's, who's going to be different from that of a peer, and they are likely to have a different point of view completely from the policymakers, because an individual's patient's point of view is going to be probably focused very much on his or her experience of the disease, whereas it starts becoming broader for the other stakeholders.
Right.
Now, again, as we discussed, these are external views of the environment. The next step that we look at is internal, as to what kind of skills do we have? What kind of a workforce do we have? What are our external professional networks that we have, which will help make our product successful? Do we have champions there? Do we have the right skill sets associated with either developing the product or marketing the product, manufacturing the product, or for that matter, all three of them? Uh-huh. When you take the internal environment and you juxtapose it on the external environment, it starts giving us some sense of what the overall opportunity looks like, which is right for us as a company. And it is then bespoke to us, and that allows us to also define a strategy, a path that essentially all of us can buy into. That would be situation analysis.
That actually reminds me, I do have a visual our external forces, which is on the left, and then we have the internal forces, which are actually on our right. And here what we are trying to define is the strengths, the weakness, opportunities and threats combined affect the product performance, its development and its launch readiness and market performance. Am I right?
That would be correct.
So this was all about our situation analysis. Now what about the scenario planning?
Right. So as the term suggests, it's composed of two terms, which is scenario and planning. So scenario is simply nothing but a belief about the future. Mm-hmm. Because future is not yet there. So essentially all we can do is we can try and predict it. Mm-hmm. We can make the best guess estimate that we have with the knowledge, the tools that we have to be able to say what the future would look like. Right. Once we have done the scenario analysis, then that basically should translate to the opportunity that future presents to us, or for that matter, the risks it presents to us. Mm-hmm. And planning is nothing but a set of actions that we will take to either maximize the opportunities or to minimize the risks, or both.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Right? And that, when you put this together to essentially building a belief about the future and identifying the impact it has on us and putting a plan in place, putting a set of actions in place to be able to take care of that impact, positive or negative, that is scenario planning.
Basically, what we are trying to do here is the scenario analysis is all about identifying alternative futures and their implications.
That would be correct.
In short, if I can just say that both of these scenario planning as well as situation analysis, these two combined, they provide the necessary 360 degree feedback so that to running the businesses.
That is correct. That is actually these two are the most important tools for us to be able to run a business.
Uh-huh. Okay. So let me put you on the hot seat and ask you, why do you think a prospective customer should choose RAS over others?
Okay. So let's look at our team. So if you can bring the visual for our team, so at least that way everybody gets a view of who we are. First thing that you notice is that we are a very concentrated group of people. We are not a large company. We are a boutique organization. So that's one thing. We are, and the second thing that you also notice is that between the 10 of us, we are essentially between the 9 and the 10, 9, 10 of us, we carry about 200 man years worth of experience, which tells you that all of our associates have a significant work experience per se. And that allows us to essentially not only be efficient about it, but also really have be very context sensitive when it comes to delivering on any bespoke project. Now, let's look at some of our metrics. We've been in existence for this since 2014. Over the years, we have actually worked across 8 therapeutic areas with 35 or so diseases that we have looked at in detail, both from a medical and a commercial point of view. We have, in those 35 indications, we have actually evaluated more than 1,600 compounds, both from a scientific and from a clinical and from a commercial point of view. We have looked into about over 10,000 trials. We have actually profiled about 60 companies to really get a deeper handle into their mindset and a deep financial analysis of the top 40 pharma companies. And over the course of this time, we have evaluated over 300,000 partnerships, whether they involve business development, whether it involve mergers and acquisition, or whether they involve joint ventures of classical in-licensing, out-licensing kind of deals. When you put the team structure together and with the metrics that we have just presented, what you notice here is that this allows us to have a good sense of not only the strength of our collective intelligence, but the actual evidence of that intelligence in action with these metrics, that makes us credible.
Actually, when I look at the slide, though I was also a part of some of these projects, I do not know what and what other team members were doing because I was so engrossed into my own. It actually gives us a sense that yes, we do have the right tools, we do have the right mindset, we do have the right experts, and actually we have the inbuilt capability to deliver such complicated and complex projects.
That would be correct.
This part where it's like, how can we get in touch with you or with RAS?
So the links for that lead us to lead anybody to contact us are given in the description. Although my email is 24/7 active, aditya@raslss.com. You can reach us on our website. We have a Twitter handle. And now we are actually, you know, producing content and posting it on YouTube and as well as audio podcast platforms. So anywhere you can touch, you have a comment, you have a request, we will be there to serve you.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Thank you, Aditya. So before we actually sign it off here, I would like to ask our audience to follow us on Twitter. We are available on LinkedIn. And there is also this contact page where you can get in touch with RAS altogether, or you can visit the website, that is www.raslss.com. Let us know your comments there. Lastly, what I like our audience is to follow us on YouTube. We do have our audio podcast series also there. And this is the first of all our Vodcast series. And if you guys have any questions, just post it on the comments. We are very tech savvy guys and we answer it very frequently. And thanks to Ram, Sakshi Saini and Aditya Bal.
Thank you very much.
And watch out for our next episode. So, yes, we're signing off. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.